Hello. If someone comes to me with a concern na yung anak ko hindi lumilingon kapag tinatawag ko, before I even suspect anything else like screen time or other disorders, the first thing I ask is, naririnig ka ba nila? Because hearing is so important to speech and language development because if you can't hear something, you cannot identify it and you will not be able to imitate it or learn it. So I want you to know how to check for your child's hearing kahit dyan lang sa bahay nyo so you can rule out hearing impairment that will affect their learning how to talk. So tara, usap tayo. Let's get talking. Hi, I'm Teacher Kay and I'm a certified speech language pathologist. Today's topic is about hearing or pandinig para ma-check nyo kung factor nga ba ito sa mga communication delay ng anak ninyo. So first, let's go and talk about milestones. So yung milestones, again, are what guides us to see kung ano yung average skills na napapakita ng mga bata at certain ages of their development. So by 3 months old, usually ang baby nakaka-recognize na yan ng familiar voices of either a parent or a sibling or basta nung laging kasama sa bahay. Usually what happens is kapag nakarinig sila ng familiar voice, makakapansin kayo ng mga changes in their body language. So either makita nyong na-soothe sila or na-calm sila, or minsan sometimes mapapangiti sila. And then by around 6 months old, they will be able to turn their eyes or even their head toward a familiar voice or sound. And by 12 months old, we usually expect na makakagaya na sila or at least sinusubukan nilang gumaya ng mga sounds or even short words. So these are very important milestones when it comes to hearing. Pero idagdag ko na rin that there are other indications that might show na baka hindi ka naririnig ng anak nyo. So the first one I said in the intro was kapag hindi sila lumilingon sa inyo pag tinawag or hindi man lang lumilingon to any sounds in the environment. That's why usually kapag sinasabi yung concern sa akin, ang una kong tanong lagi, pero napapansin nyo po ba kung lumilingon kapag may tumahol na aso or may malakas na busina sa labas, etc. Other more subtle indications could be yung parang napapansin nyo na medyo inattentive yung bata. Minsan parang nakikinig, minsan parang hindi nakikinig, or baka kasi hindi naririnig. Or if beyond 1 year old, wala pa talagang ni kahit anong speech sounds yung na-produce nung bata beyond babbling. Because contrary to what other people might think, even the hearing impaired babies can coo and babble because they may accidentally produce these sounds. But if beyond 1 year old, walang meaningful speech sounds na ginamit, medyo indication na po ito na baka merong hearing loss yung bata. So if you notice limited or no speech, or if meron namang speech kahit konti, pero yung napoproduce na sounds, either nagkukulang-kulang ng mga, let's say, certain consonants, or kapag muffled yung tunog ng consonants. Also, try to observe for behaviors like, napapansin nyo ba na parang pag nakikinig yung anak nyo, may fine-favor siyang isang tenga, like lalapit siya, tas parang ganito siya makikinig sa'yo, or from malayo, lalapit siya para lang makinig sa'yo. Or parang may mga times na naiintindihan ka naman niya kapag nasa quiet environment kayo, pero pag pumunta na kayo sa isang environment na maraming iba-ibang klaseng sounds, parang hindi ka na niya maintindihan at all. So these are only some of the most common signs that the child may be hearing impaired. So for a majority of babies who are born in hospitals, meron po tayong tinatawag na newborn screening. And kasama na ho yun usually sa mga lahat ng babies, ginagawa na nila yun. They check for everything and that includes hearing bago kanila paalisin sa ospital. Now, for whatever reason, mas lalong nandito tayo sa Pilipinas, kunyari ikay nanganak sa bahay or nagpa-midwife or some other smaller clinic that does not provide or include the newborn screening test, dapat po kayo po mismo yung mag-seek out ng newborn screening test within the first 3 weeks of the baby's life. Kasama nga po kasi dito yung hearing para malaman natin if functional yung hearing ng baby ninyo. Typically, the tests that are used for your newborn screening are one of the two or both, ABR or Auditory Brainstem Response Test or the OAE or Autoacoustic Emission Test. Usually po kasi ito yung mga medyo hindi masyadong invasive na procedure at pwedeng natutulog yung baby habang ginagawa to. And makikita nila yung responses ng baby's ear to brain connections. Very simplistically speaking. But just because your child passed the newborn screening test doesn't mean that something couldn't have happened along the way. And I'm not saying this to scare you, I'm just giving you the facts. Now there are several types of hearing impairments and the most common are the conductive or something that happens externally. For example, sobrang hindi nyo pala napapansin na wax former yung baby nyo. So ang dami-dami ng impacted na tutule or cerumen dun sa loob ng ears ng baby nyo na wala nang nakaka-pass through na sound. So that's one possible thing. Pwede rin hindi nyo napansin, naglalaro yung baby nyo, tapos may naipasok pala siya dun sa tenga nyo, na-trauma pala yung eardrum, and that could also be causing some sort of hearing impairment. Or, hindi nyo napansin kasi kayo na-tolerate nyo, pero kasama nyo si baby, tas biglang may sobrang lakas na sound. Kahit momentarily lang yun nangyari, some of very loud sounds can really affect a baby's eardrum. There's another type of hearing impairment na nasa loob naman. There is a structure in our inner ear called the cochlea and it looks like a shell. And siya yung responsible for receiving the sound waves and transmitting them to our brain. Now, if something happens to our cochlea, and sometimes people are born with this or there are other developmental disorders that affect the cochlea, or there are infections like meningitis that can cause this, then this may be what is causing the child's hearing loss. And then there's also the hearing loss na mix of inner and outer. So like I said, the cochlear or something external, and very original, ang tawag sa kanya ay mixed hearing impairment. And then there's another hearing impairment called central, which has something naman to do with the brain. Like hindi ma-process ng brain mo yung sinesend na information from your ear. But okay, napadaldal na naman ako. So our point now today is to check if may hearing impairment nga yung baby ninyo. So before you even get the official tests at the hospital, you can do some of these behavioral tests at home. So usually what I do, especially with very young babies na hindi mo pa naman maturuan to respond in a particular way, set up a time and a place where it is very quiet, kayong dalawa lang sa room, walang other extraneous noises. Tapos habang naglalaro siya, sana yung linalaro niya walang tunog, punta ka sa likod niya or somewhere na hindi ka niya nakikita and make random sounds. So sometimes I start with just loud clapping noises. So habang nandun ka sa likod ng baby na nagpe-play, so one very easy way of telling is making environmental noises. Different kinds of noises around the baby and see if mapapalingon siya or kahit hindi siya lumingon kung nag-startle siya. Or mapapansin mo na parang napatigil siya kasi may gulat factor. So these are things to look out for. Next, if okay yung response to environmental sounds, we want to check kung naririnig niya yung speech sounds. Siyempre, ito na yung importanteng titingnan natin because this will determine kung maririnig nila yung sinasabi sa kanila para matutunan nila kung paano nila gamitin yung the same speech sounds themselves. For this one, I follow the same 6 sounds plus silence na ginagamit sa Ling 6 test. I won't get super into it. I can probably make a separate video about that. Pero just to be very simple about it, the 6 sounds are M, A, U, E, Sh, and S. So 6 sounds plus silence. Lagi kong sinasama yung silence and this is important for older kids. But for now, like I said, di ko i-discuss yung buong Ling 6 muna. For now, I'm only going to explain why we use these 6 sounds. We choose these 6 sounds because they represent the different sound frequencies across the sound frequencies in a range of speech. Meaning, lahat ng mga sounds na nakakreate natin when talking happen between 250 hertz and 4,000 hertz, roughly in that range. So these 6 sounds represent only, syempre may mga ibang sounds na kasama nilang mga sounds na yan, pero they represent the speech sounds in that range. With M having the lowest frequency and S having the highest frequency. Now, just like how I showed you with how to present kanina, di ba yung environmental sounds, dapat quiet yung room, dapat kayo lang, dapat walang ibang distractors, ganun rin dito. But a special consideration is you take note yung distance mo from the child. So kahit nasa likod ka ng child, first we want to try it from 6 feet away. So kung nandito yung bata, measure kayo ng 6 feet away from the child, usually behind the child na hindi kayo nakikita. So again, present the sounds randomly, hindi yung parang sunod-sunod. You have to give them time to respond and also to not pick up any patterns of, uy, yun na yung susunod, tapos kaya lilingon-lingon siya. Hindi mo na matel kung lumilingon siya sa sound or dahil expectation niyang lumingon. So first, you want to do this completely perpendicular to the child. And then after you present, ganyan, and again, notice for their behaviors, then you may want to move obliquely to one ear. Ear, kunyari favoring the left ear, and then after that, present mo naman na favoring the right ear. And then based on the results of that, when you presented all the Ling 6 sounds, as parang hindi pa rin ako naririnig nung anak ko, you can try to go closer and see kung mag-change yung response niya if you are closer to one ear or another, or just the fact that you are closer. Just make sure na when you present the sounds, lahat ng pag-present mo ng sounds are in the same manner. Pareho ng pitch, hindi yung andito ka, tas nabi mo, pero yung lumapit ka, iba na, kasi mag-iiba na yung frequency. So make sure you present it in the same pitch and also the same volume. Itong procedure na kakakwento ko lang is only for detection pa lang. We want to know if they even heard what you're saying. Wala pa tayo dun sa discrimination and identification part, which you can do with older children. But like I said, maybe I'll just discuss how to administer the Ling 6 sounds for another video. But just to check kung naririnig kayo ng anak nyo or hindi, those were my tips and I hope that they help. Kapag feeling nyo, parang hindi talaga ako naririnig nung bata, punta na po kayo sa doktor, magpa-check po kayo, and you may want to ask for a hearing test. Why is this important? Because a hearing test will be able to show you what type of hearing impairment your child has and what severity. At kapag na-determine na yon, doon lang natin siya mabibigyan ng intervention by means of paano natin i-amplify or paano natin siya bibigyan ng means para makarinig siya. At doon pa lang natin masisimula ng ating speech therapy or speech intervention for the child. So step by step lang po tayo, and I'm here to support you for whatever you may need along the way. If you have any questions or clarifications, do get in touch with me on Facebook and Instagram at Teacher K Talks. It may take a while for me to get back to you, but I promise that I read everything. And if you like this video, please do share it. And if hindi pa po kayo nagsusubscribe, I would love it if pindutin nyo na po yung red subscribe button na yan, and join our community of empowered families. So thank you, and hanggang sa muli, happy talking, mabuhay!